Gavin Holmes, Trade Guider Systems CEO, author of the book Trading in the Shadow of the Smart Money, follower of ESA Analysis founder Tom Williams, speaker at various Forex-devoted conferences worldwide, participant of prestigious Forex expositions in New York and Los Angeles, author of the lectures on ESA Analysis for Chicago CME Group.
Why have you chosen the name Trading in the Shadow of the Smart Money for your book?
Well, it's a very good question. The reason I did was because when I was taught to trade by Tom Williams, he himself was the smart money. Now, when you trade in harmony with professionals, there are two types of traders, the smart money and the dumb money. And the smart money are the big institutional money. So when you trade in their shadow as a retail trader or a small-time trader, you can actually pick up what I call the crumbs of the trade. That means as they come in with their large orders, 500,000, a million contracts, we can see the footprints. So the name of the book was to show the trader who's maybe just starting in trading or has even got experience that you can trade after the big players have left the footprint. You can trade in their shadow. And I woke up one morning and the book title just was there. And I looked on the internet and no one had got that title. So it was sort of destined to be. The trouble was, once I got it, I had to write the book and it took 2 years. But that's the reason it's called Trading in the Shadow. You're following the institutional money using volume spread analysis.
You mentioned VSA originator Tom Williams as your teacher. Did you change his method in any way?
A good question. In the 15 years since I've been doing this, there's very little I needed to change about Tom's work because it's pretty much as perfect as it's going to get. However, what I did develop on the back of Tom's work was what we call the sequences, the VSA sequences. And they're based on the numbers that are in the indicator dialog boxes. Because what I could see was that when the big players come in, the high volume comes in. And then it's followed by low volume at that same level. So what I was able to do was, taking Tom's original work, was to produce a scanner that alerted me to trade setups. And when I was able to do that, it made the job of finding the trades so much easier. But Tom's work will always stay the same. I don't think it will ever be improved upon because it's raw supply and demand analysis. And you know, the guy is a genius, and I'm pleased that he chose me to teach this on his behalf.
What is the most important quality or character trait for a trader?
Belief. You've got to believe in yourself. It's so many traders I see who are losing, have no self-confidence. They're probably poorly trained. They maybe haven't got the right system. But you've got to have belief. And if you have that in your heart and you're passionate about trading, as I am, everything will fall into place. But after your belief, you have to be trained properly. I believe knowledge and the correct knowledge about the market is most important, because there's a lot of misleading information out there. In fact, there's too much information about the market. The market is moved by universal forces that are at work all around us. Supply and demand is the key force that moves the market. If you learn just how to read the imbalances of that, you'll be successful in the market. I'd say to any trader that's really serious, please believe in yourself, practice, and most importantly, be disciplined. Don't just be a gambler in the market, be a trader, which means you're making informed professional decisions.